With the holidays coming to a screeching halt and for most of the country, some cold weather in store, it can be hard to stay happy around this time of year.
Well, don't fret. Sonia Lubomirsky. Yes, yes, she's author of The Howl of Happiness. And Lolita, founder of Designs by Lolita, are here with a few tips on how to beat those post-holiday blues. I'm just trying to be happy.
Be the character. Okay, so we're going to talk in a minute about the parties and the fun.
But we're going to get on to that.
But we're beginning with the holiday blues. That's
do we have the blues, Sonia?
Well, you know, we look forward to, we anticipate the holidays for so long, long before they begin. Yeah. And actually, research shows that that anticipation period can be even more positive than the experience being anticipated. So no wonder we feel a huge letdown.
Right.
Is it like, I don't know, your state of mind changes, obviously. Is it something you can just bounce right back if you just think
about it? Well, that's right. So research shows that a great deal of happiness is under our control. So we can all practice happiness-increasing strategies if we do it with effort and with purpose. So, for example, we could embrace the little things in our day. You know, so for some people, that could be listening to their favorite piece of music or playing catch with their kids or sitting down and enjoying a glass of orange juice. Researchers that drinking orange juice makes people happy. So whatever, you know, you can relish, appreciate, savor, that's going to take your mind off of the negative things, the stresses, and put you in a positive mindset.
See, I feel relieved when it's all over. Not the blues. I feel like, oh, all right.
Thank God, yeah.
Yeah, because, you know, there's just a lot of pressure on you during the holidays as well.
Because there's a lot of strife, and sometimes there's friction and hostility. You know, there's a saying that a mother can never be happier than her least happy child.
Yeah. Yes.
So if there's one person in your family who's creating friction, who's drinking too much, you know, that could ruin the time for everyone.
All right, well, let's talk
about... Mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy.
Well, let's talk about drinking. All right, so you're saying throw a party's a nice way to kind of snap out of it. Tell us, Lolita.
Pick a theme and throw a fun party.
Okay.
It's easy. Okay, so, ladies, have you had a margarita when it's 20 outside?
Yes.
Have you tried that? And it's cheerful, right? So this is the
like
first
a summer
idea.
Party?
A summer party.
In the winter.
Nothing here for
nothing.
Sonia. I'll share
there
with
we go.
Sonia. Thank you. Yeah.
Have a dress code, shorts and shirts, sweats over, flip-flops required. Don't forget the guacamole.
Oh, sorry, hold on.
That's okay. Got that.
That's good.
That's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
All right, next up. Keep next slide on down.
Oh, thank you.
Blue is a great color. Doesn't have to be a feeling. So you can wear it, you can eat it.
And it's a blues party?
It's a blues party. Everything's blue. The chips, the M&M's, the blueberry mojitos. So you can really make it fun. You can even do blue lights, which is fun.
Oh, that's cool.
And have your guests wear blue.
Okay.
It's just something
that's
simple
a good
and something
idea.
Fun.
All right, let's continue on the cocktail theme.
Yeah.
Well, now this is...
So far, this seems to be the answer to all your problems.
drink them away.
Here we go. This is not just your normal orange juice, ladies. Okay. The cocktail exchange idea is about basically bringing a cocktail in a bag. That's the theme.
Okay.
So all of your guests put together one drink in a bag and bring it to the party. And then you draw names and everybody gets back. And the key is you buy the ingredients for the drink and put it in the bag. It can be very simple. You can pick simple cocktails, like three ingredients or less is easiest. You don't have to do the full-size bottles.
Okay.
You can just do the miniatures, which makes it really easy.
All right, let's talk sweets, because s'mores is a great party to have. Come on.
Nothing like hot chocolate to steam things up on a really cold day.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a really fun afternoon party, or even for kids.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want to make it an adult dessert party, have a little bit of chocolate liqueur on hand in case they want a libation.
Okay.
So we have s'mores here. We have marshmallows. You can even do pound cake. So s'mores, a childhood dream, can become an adult. Great dessert for the evening.
And that brings back, I guess, childhood memories.
Yes. That's right. And we have so many positive memories about, you know, camp. And so triggering those memories is going to make people happy and relieve some of that stress that you have after the holidays.
Right. 10 seconds left, but so potluck's a good one to have.
Potluck. Yeah. But the new theme here is pick an ingredient and have everyone bring a dish with that ingredient. And this is maple syrup.
Oh, okay.
And believe it or not, everything tastes totally different. It's just a creative twist on how to
syrup.
Do a potluck.
Yeah.
Okay.
All great ideas.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, both of you.
Thank
we really appreciate it.